Yasmin. Areas like Newtown on Oahu could be split in two, and longtime lawmakers would be forced to run against each other in the upcoming election. Redistricting is a hot issue right now, and we could learn if a lawsuit is filed. The state's race to the top grant is another huge issue facing our state because $75 million in federal dollars is at risk. And joining us this morning to talk about that, plus how local Democrats are gearing up for the presidential election, is Lieutenant Governor Brian Schatz. Good morning.
Good morning.
Great to see you. So thanks for coming on this morning. We've got a lot of issues to talk about. Redistricting, the big one today. And, you know, a lot of voters will be confused because they're not quite sure who they're going to be able to vote for. And I think you can add some perspective to that.
Well, that is the confusion. You know, every 10 years, the census comes out, which shows where the population has shifted. And so districts get redone according to how the population moves. So you always have roughly equal representation throughout the state. That's why the Big Island is getting another Senate seat, because their population is growing. But as a result, certain districts either shrink or get merged. And what's happening right now is there's a question as to what's fair and what's proportional and all the rest of it. And there's usually a fight over reapportionment because this has to do with people's political livelihoods. But the impact for citizens is right now you don't know what your choices are. Or if you want to run for office and you're not currently an incumbent, you can't even sign up to be a candidate. And so however this gets resolved, it has to get resolved relatively quickly so that the Office of Elections can print maps, so people can sign up to be candidates, and most importantly, so citizens can start to engage in what are their choices for their local representatives and senators.
So this really puts a timeline on the election season. It kind of condenses it a little bit because of all this,
right? Absolutely does, and especially for primary elections. Because of a federal law, our primary election is going to be much, much sooner than it normally is. It's usually around mid-September. It'll be mid-August in any case. Mm-hmm. So you're really compressing the time period. And so voters are going to have to pay extra attention this year because obviously it's a very important election. Everybody is up for re-election except for the governor and myself. We're in four-year terms. But everybody else in the state of Hawaii, including our congressional delegation mm-hmm. and one United States Senate seat, and most of the mayor's races are all up, so it's going to be a very exciting year.
Let's move on to race to the top, and people are still wondering if Hawaii will be able to get the $75 million because it's at risk now. And the governor went to Washington to talk with education officials federally, and now we're learning that they're going to be able to come here sometime this month to talk with state officials here. So what's the latest on that, and do you think that we'll be able to keep this money?
Well, I think it's too early to tell. Obviously, the last rejection of the collective bargaining agreement was a significant setback. That's the bad news. The good news is that Governor Abercrombie has been in constant contact with our Secretary of Education, Arne Duncan, mm-hmm. And met with, as you said, federal officials over the last week. Also, we just had an additional collective bargaining agreement that was ratified that allows for a 17% more instruction time in what they're calling zones of innovation. So certain school districts, there's going to be more teaching, and the teachers are going to get compensated for that time. That was part of Race to the Top. And the other thing that's important is in terms of teacher evaluation, which was one of the key objectives in the race, we were able to work with the Board of Education, and they adopted a lot of that through their own rulemaking process. Mm-hmm. So we're moving forward step by step. Obviously, the collective bargaining agreement rejection was a big setback. There's no doubt about that. But we're now kind of back on our feet and making progress bit by bit. So when the federal officials come, I think we'll be able to show some progress.
Local Democrats are gearing up for Ohana for Obama. It's a little difficult to say. It's on Sunday. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, it's Sunday from 1 to 3 at Washington Middle School. next to Zippy's on King Street mm-hmm. In Macaulay, Makiki. And the idea is, we've still got the president's back. We're still strongly supporting his agenda, and we understand that we want to send a message to the rest of the United States that we really still support President Obama. We support his agenda. He's been a tremendously successful foreign policy president, and he's also been able to turn the second greatest recession or depression in United States history into slow and steady growth. So we support him, and we want everybody in the state of Hawaii to come out and show our support for our president.
All right. I know that there have been mixed reviews on his presidency, and the Republicans would disagree with that. But we will definitely be covering the news on Sunday with the rally. Lieutenant Governor Ryan Schatz, thank you so much for joining us. I really appreciate it.
Nice to see you.
And don't forget, if you'd like to see this interview again, you can head to the morning section of our website, KITV.com. It is 6:17.